What is up, I Love Basketball TV. It's Coach Ryan Rizuki, and we are breaking down the perfect shooting form to help you to have a much more consistent and viable jump shot. Let's get to it. So step one is gonna be to get your shooting hand in the center of the basketball. So I like to split the middle, index, middle right here. You might like the index in the middle, and you might like the middle finger in the middle, but again, I'm split. Now, what you cannot do is have your hand on the side. That's not acceptable. Your hand in front without the wrinkled wrist, completely unacceptable, and your hand on the side. Those are the three most common ways that you're gonna see people hold the basketball here, here, and here, right? Or at least incorrectly. So once we have our hand placed perfectly in the center, we got a nice wrinkled wrist, we're already in a good space to have good alignment. Step two is to take our guide hand and to have it here on the side, but not just on the side, because from here, my hands are too close together. I'm actually gonna take my pinky and drop it below, almost to the point where it's touching my quad, not that low, but really, really close. So now I'm on the side, but I'm also slightly on top, so I have a really good grip of the ball. So this way, as I go into my jab steps, as I go into my pass fakes, I can keep that consistent grip and allow that ball to come up, release, and shoot, right? And of course, that's all gonna be one consistent motion. It's not gonna be one, two, three. It's gonna be up and boom. That ball will just kind of glide off of that guide hand. So once we have good hand placement with both hands, this one wrinkled in the center, this one on the side, and slightly, just ever so slightly on top. Hand placement's number one. Alignment is gonna be the third thing that we're gonna talk about. So hand placement looks good. Right hand, left hand. Now we gotta bring the ball up from this quad, through my chest, through my eyeball, in a perfectly straight line. You want to avoid out here, out of our frame, and across our frame. So once that ball starts to travel this way, that's an issue. You can see my elbow popping out, my hand's not underneath the ball, and I won't be able to shoot the ball correctly. So now you have your perfect hand placement, right hand, left hand, you got good alignment bringing that ball up. You know, your set point, you can see in my face here, my set point comes up right above my forehead. Not crazy high, but right above. Yours can play in any space between your nose and right above your forehead. This is perfect space for your set point. But if that ball starts coming up and then out underneath your chin, that's an issue. If the ball goes up, covers your face on this side or this side, that's an issue. If the ball comes up and goes on top of your head or behind your head, that is also an issue. So allow that ball to come up in the straightest line possible, and anywhere in this space is good to have that ball start coming up and then start going out towards the rim. But you definitely don't want it to cover the side of your face, you definitely don't want it to come from underneath your chin, and you don't want it to come behind your head. So the ball comes up, and then as we release, you can see that my elbow is right here in line with my eyebrow or just slightly above it. And this is gonna help you with your arc. So as you bring it up, we're shooting it, we're releasing it, and we can have this consistency right here. What you don't want again is to have that ball come here with my arc too low or my arc too high. So if we have good alignment and we're bringing the ball up and we're shooting it, I should end up with my hand in the rim right there and my arc, eyebrow, and elbow in that same level. Now with our feet, focusing on our balance. When we shoot that ball, it's really important that we have a good energy transfer. So that ball should start here at the quad. The reason why I like this is because you don't want to have players that shoot the ball like this. This is not good for your range. So don't sit in this stance. You want to sit in this stance, and as the ball comes up, your body comes up. You can see the ball and my hips work together. Boom. Every single time I shoot it, not this, because now I'm pushing the ball and I don't want to push the ball. I want to have good fluidity, good release. So now that's our energy transfer. Our feet are good, balance, right foot slightly above the left foot, about hip width apart, not too wide, not too close. We're here, ball's low, body's low, ball rises, body rises, straight shot, release, and you can see that the guide hand has not moved at all. Okay, so now that we've talked about how to shoot the ball correctly, some more common issues, of course, is going to be off-hand involvement. And one of the most common ways you see this is because hands are too close together. So as you shoot the ball and your hands are too close together, what we need to do is make sure that we have good hand placement, separate those, so we're not having to push the ball with both hands. The more we can separate them, the less you can use the off-hand to push the ball. If your offhand is an issue, the best suggestion I have for you is to take your thumb and your index finger off the ball. And now you have 1, 2, 3 in your palm, and you can bring it up and release, but there's no way that you can push or turn that wrist to allow that rotation to mess up. So we bring it up, we release, good rotation. If you struggle with rotation, you can try a 3-finger drill here. 1, 2, 3 with your shooting hand. I have here 3, I'm next to the rim, and I'm gonna release, boom, and just focus on rotation, making sure that these 3 fingers are the ones that are pushing it through the rim and not these last 2 fingers. So we've already helped you to fix your thumb flick. We've already helped you to fix the wrist turning, if that's an issue with your shot. And if you have a problem with your rhythm, a great way to fix that is to sit in a chair. So as you're sitting in the chair, you're here, this way your body can't get lower. Because some players who do this, boom, want to drop as the ball goes up. So if you have the ball here and you're sitting in a chair, you can't go any lower than this. All you can do is go up. So that's gonna help your rhythm. So you can fix your rhythm by sitting in a chair, standing up and shooting. You can get your offhand off the ball by just taking these 2 fingers off, and you can fix your rotation by putting only these 3 fingers on. Once you have fixed each individual part of your shot, the whole cohesive shot together will look completely perfect. We hope you enjoyed today's video, so make sure to hit that thumbs up button if you did, and subscribe as we're dropping new videos every single week. So make sure you hit that notification bell. And if you hit the link and the pinned comment down below, it's gonna give you access to our new shooting program. So make sure that you go get that one, as it's an incredible program and it's gonna help you a ton. We'll catch you guys in the next video. Know that they ride or die. I keep boys by my side. Know that they ride or die. I keep boys by my side.